Most of us don't get enough calcium through our food. When we need 1000 milligrams of calcium, most get between 500 to 750 milligrams. Therefore, supplementation with calcium is needed. However, there is so much variety amongst calcium supplements, and it gets so very confusing to choose the right one. In this video, we'll discuss how one should choose a calcium supplement. So let's begin this health sachet. The main form of calcium supplements are calcium carbonate, calcium citrate, and somewhat rarer are calcium gluconate, calcium lactate, calcium phosphate, and even a blend called calcium citrate malate. Out of these, calcium carbonate is the most common, convenient, and cheap version. However, it needs stomach acid for its absorption in the intestine, so you have to take it with meals. Calcium citrate, on the other hand, does not need stomach acid for its absorption, so it can even be taken on empty stomach. And therefore, calcium citrate, though it's expensive, is advised for conditions such as absorption disorders, a condition called inflammatory bowel disease, and a specific condition called achlorhydria, in which stomach doesn't produce enough hydrochloric acid for digestion. Another thing to remember is calcium carbonate has 40% elemental calcium, whereas calcium citrate has 21%. Calcium gluconate has 9% and calcium lactate has 11%. Therefore, to get the same amount of elemental calcium, you need much lesser quantity of calcium carbonate, making one need to take lesser amount of calcium tablets. Always make sure you check the label on the tablets. The requirement of calcium is usually mentioned in terms of elemental calcium and not the quantity of the calcium salt. It is usually mentioned as percentage DV or percentage of daily value. Daily value for calcium is typically 1000 milligram. So if it says 40% DV, it means 40% of 1000 milligram or 400 milligram of elemental calcium per serving in that tablet. Another thing to remember is not to take any tablet which has more than 500 milligram of elemental calcium at a time. For example, if it says 1000 mg, don't take it because your body cannot absorb more than 500 milligram very easily. In fact, my preference is for 250 milligrams because lesser quantity is very easily absorbed by body, and as the quantity increases at a time, your body starts absorbing less and less of that. So you may think you consume 1000 milligram of elemental calcium, but your body ends up absorbing only 500 or 600. Therefore, you have to take lesser amount of calcium divided over multiple times in a day. It is best to have a calcium tablet which has vitamin D also in it. This is because most of the urban people have deficiency of vitamin D. And if you have that deficiency, your body doesn't absorb calcium that well. So a calcium supplement with vitamin D is a very good idea. My personal preference is also to have a calcium supplement which has magnesium in it. It has been found that many people are deficient in magnesium, though not everyone is. And if you have this supplemental calcium, but you are deficient in magnesium, you end up risking heart problems or kidney stones. So in summary, calcium carbonate is the best option for most of us, unless we have some absorption disorders or we have very poor stomach acid due to old age. If you found this video useful, hit the like button. You can subscribe to this channel by clicking in the circle. And to see more videos of this type, click in the rectangular box on my left. Remember, ignorance is a very bad idea when it comes to staying healthy. Thank you.